beim Plezierklettern.
When climbing for fun, you can normally rely on bolts, which means you're always well protected and can focus purely upon the climb difficulty. With alpine routes, on the other hand, in addition to having the climbing ability, you also need the skills to place your own protection points and set up anchors for a belay. It is essential to have the right equipment with you and to know how to use it correctly. On a true alpine climb, I'm generally only going to have questionable anchors for my belay, since I'll be building my belay using friends, cams, and any available pitons. As these are all questionable protection points, I can't set up a series connection. Instead, I must create what is called a distribution of load anchor. There are three fundamental rules you must observe when setting up an anchor. First, the loads must be distributed as equally as possible across all protection pieces. Second, if one piece fails, there should be no sudden jolt caused by the sling slipping and adding additional force to the system. And thirdly, in terms of importance, the whole anchor must be able to resist a sudden upwards movement. Otherwise, the belayer may also be jerked upwards, hit the rock, and let go of the brake hand. If I'm going to set up a belay using two questionable pieces, first, I'll need a long enough sling. This could be a length of Kevlar cord or a sewn sling. To connect the two protection points, I clip the sling into the upper and lower pieces. Then I create a central point for my anchor by attaching a carabiner using a girth hitch. With the South Tyrolean belay, a sewn sling is threaded through two protection points and a distribution of load is set up. This is done by threading a girth hitch through the top piece. Then simply feed the sling through the lower piece, bring the two loops together, and fix the central point carabiner using a girth hitch. Using a sewn sling in this way, you can set up a distribution of load quickly and without knots. And should either of the two pieces fail, no sudden additional force will be added to the system. Regardless of which anchor system you set up, each anchor has a central point. This is the point where the personal anchor and partner's belay run together. It may be a carabiner or a hitch formed from a sling. Once my anchor is set up, I'm ready to bring up my follower. At this moment, the fall tension on the anchor can only act downwards, not upwards. But as soon as the follower overtakes to lead, the anchor should ideally also withstand upward force. This is done ideally by placing a protection piece below the central point. Or if that isn't possible, then I have to ensure I create a downward direction for the anchor using my body weight. If you want to practice setting up an anchor in alpine terrain, it's best to choose a small face somewhere or the foot of a cliff and put in a few protection points using nuts, friends, rock tunnels, and look how they are positioned. Work out a suitable system and set it up. Then practice the whole setup again so that on a climb you can carry it out quickly and efficiently.